Okay. Hello, guys. So I would like to start with a story that you imagine that every day you're going from work at the same time, you have the same parameters with your body, and at one day something strange happens with you. Like you are in a fighting mode, you're running, your pulse is very high, and probably you can have this smart device with you which will recognize all these patterns and realize that something is weird going on. It can also send a message to a next police station, for example, and notify the devices of all human beings around you. So would it be very helpful for us or not? So my topic today is combining IoT and artificial intelligence, and IoT here is the smart devices, basically. So during last years, we realized that artificial intelligence are necessary to bring a lot of IoT sensors online. And also what is more important, that artificial intelligence will make sense of all these data which we stream from these devices. So in my opinion, we're gonna have a new industrial revolution in our houses and universe, and today we will talk about this. So who am I? I'm Karina Popova. This is my Twitter. I really like when someone tweets about me, so please, if you like the talk, or you can also keep touch with me and write all your questions afterwards, and we'll be happy to answer you. I work in Link Mobility Group. It's a global messaging provider. We're based in Germany. We have about 200 employees, and what is more cool is that we provide services for 400 different networks and mobile operators worldwide. We are working already for 15 years in this business that's very closely to our clients, all of them now moving to IoT sphere, and that gives us an excellent path towards new research and advancement in IoT. So to dive into the topic, I usually start with the term quantified self, because it's what bothers all of us right now. Do we live a good life? How to save our time? How to measure this? Because quantified self is basically self-knowledge through self-tracking via technology. And it's not a new thing that we're trying to measure everything. It was even in previous generation. We were always concerned about different inputs in our life, like what food we eat, what the quality of air around us, or different states, like what is the weather outside. Also different performances about our physical activities or mental performances. Because nowadays we have all these cool applications, and once per day can, based on your social media activities or how often you use your phone, can send you a message. Sometimes it sends me a message like, you don't have a depression today. And then I feel, I don't have a depression today. And it's really cool. And basically what information technologies do nowadays, they force a transformation from old style, old fashioned system and technologies to a highly available and highly intelligent application and systems. So, we predict that 2020 we will have tons of devices per person and tons of data processed per second, and we are not even taking into account connected cats and dogs, which also will be a case I think in some near future. And we all have a question, how all this data will be actionable after some time. Because a big data, IoT at some point will be the highest source of data on our planet. And to find the available insights in this data, we will need to measure it real time. And one of the main problem right now, it's a performance, how we'll perform all this data. So artificial intelligence on the other side nowadays already provide invaluable assistance in speeding up our tasks. And I believe that in the near future, it will be definitely go beyond self-driving cars and aircrafts. Because at the moment when it will fully simulate the human brain, we will have kind of intelligent explosion on our planet, and the rate of innovation will increase exponentially. There are some examples that at the moment when it will create a consciousness, maybe you know it's from the famous movies like I said, Marvin, for example, when he was super intelligent but was sad that he still needs to open doors for people, or a bad HAL 9000 that he was doing everything against people. Do we need to have it in our future or not? So this is one of the terms which I really like, that IoT won't work without artificial intelligence, because we have an enormous amount of data and our human brain can't analyze it and can't find a needle in this high stack of data. And because what is more important for us is that this data which we receive from all these devices is more, it's inform immediate actions, because only this is interesting for us. So basically big data by itself means nothing, only relevant data will mean something for us. And to explain why IoT will not work without artificial intelligence, I will just bring briefly show you a some intelligence there, yeah. And so there is different steps in IoT functional view. And first of all, we need to create an information. It's always done with sensors or different devices. Then we need to some communication, how we will send this data from the device to the system. Then we need a special system. We need to integrate all this information and manage it. Then we need to analyze this information. And for these purposes, we need, of course, an intelligent system which can process all this information. And then we need to do some action on this data, which means some different behaviors. So if you will look and focus only on these three components, this is exactly where we need artificial intelligence for IoT. We have, of course, some challenges in this topic, because we still need to enable machines to send this data and be connected in real time. We also need to, we can't think about like a single model or algorithm how we need to analyze this data. So we need to find different ways to understand the data. And we also, like as we developers, so closely working in IoT, we have to be able to create those services which can adapt during the time to our users. So basically when I'm talking about IoT, I say that it's a community of information, that a lot of devices around us, they gather this information and they can interact with the environment. And mostly because my company is in the messaging and mobile business, almost all my use cases today will be based on cellular connectivity, even that these IoT devices can connect in different ways. We are focused on it just because it's easy to provide use cases, a real one which already working for you to understand. And I just would like to say that given the ubiquity of these SIM-based devices, you can really achieve an unbelievable level of coverage in space and time. That's why I think it's a nice to use this. And we usually say that mobile connectivity is becoming kind of an integral part of IoT, because all these devices sometimes moving, sometimes they in a different places. And yes. Then, as developers, as IoT developers, we usually experience a lot of problems with find a suitable, globally distributed, secure way to connect IoT device and to analyze data afterwards. So, there are a lot of why we have these problems, because there are different APIs, different device configurations, network configurations. It was also very hard for us to understand sometimes some security policies of different networks. And so we kind of, inside my team, we developed some different needs, which has to be there when you are talking about future generation of IoT and artificial intelligence together. So I will just briefly give you an introduction to these needs. First, it's a connection quality. So we thought that it definitely has to be kind of we require the permanent connection with the worldwide coverage, the maximum existing possible worldwide coverage, and the possibility to switch us to the strongest network all the time. And this is what we have nowadays, where all these IoT cases are implemented. So it's quite worldwide. Another need was advanced security. So it would be very cool if we have a different IP restriction, and if we can, this connection can be locked to a specific device that no one else can access it. And also it would be very cool if we can have a different, because security is very popular topic in IoT, so we need to provide a really good level of it. And here we go with an advanced VPN tunnel. So what we saw that at the top you see how it's usually done, and at the bottom what we've done. There is an encryption on both ways, so before accessing our APN, and you don't need to have any VPN tunnel on the device or VPN client on the device. And it's less power consumption, and so we achieve some kind of this need. And then there is access to the device, because what is the main problem nowadays is that we have a lot of devices, but we can access usually a bunch of them, but not a single one. And so we thought that it would be cool if each device would have a static IP address, that is possible to have a bidirectional communication and monitor them in real time. So from this implementation side, there is no more difficulties, because what we finally achieved is that the solution is with GSM when we use. You don't need any maintenance, configuration efforts, and I will show you later what happens. And then there is also need of flexibility, in our case, the SIM cards, but it's also used for any connections. That, because we have some strange cases when people want to track a polar bears, for example, in IoT, and of course, the connectivity, the sensor device, and the connectivity solution which is inside has to be resistant to all the shock, vibrations, humidity, different temperature range. So this was the next need. And the last need, one of the most important, is control and automatization. So in our case, that you have to have control over all these devices. If you lose a control, it's this data will not bring you available results anymore. And it's really cool if you can do it in real time. And for these purposes, we developed some, like a customer portal and API. It's basically some features that you can, in real time, activate, turn on, turn off devices, track the location. You can change it from 2G to 3G, but it's more JSON related. Yeah, this is how it looks like on a customer portal, that you can, in a real time, see what your device is transferred, to which network it's attached, where does it locate it, how much money you spend on this connectivity. And of course, there is this API, which is really cool for us developers, that you can actually, on the top of it, build an artificial intelligence system which can analyze everything much easily. So this is what we got, and which will be a base for almost all my use cases. No one knows that it exists. Somehow it's a multi-network SIM card, and it's globally. What it's done nowadays, you can have your own mobile network in your hands with this SIM card. You set up by yourself all restrictions, and months ago we were awarded as a highly promising innovative technology. But how we use it finally? How IoT and artificial intelligence implemented in Germany, and what different use cases we have? Because basically we know all these payment terminals, fleet management, and security assistance, we know it for a long time. We use these products, and now IoT on top of it give us another overview. Do we really need these products? How much, how often do we use it? How suitable one solution over another one? And somehow it gives us an overview in the future, which technologies will stay with us and which will be outdated. So when we start, the first example will be in e-health monitoring. Because artificial intelligence and IoT, one of the main input nowadays in e-health topic, as it's provide, artificial intelligence provide really overview of all your health history and sometimes can predict even diagnosis for you. So we created this use case for Google Conference a year ago, and what we saw that, imagine a person, he is 82, he's feeling quite fit, and he has some problems with his heart, his pulse has to be measured, and his relative, of course, would prefer him to move rather to assisted accommodations and stay alone at home, but he would like to continue his normal life. So we created these wearable devices which can monitor all the time your lifestyle somehow. It's basically as a part of your lifestyle. And why we use the GSM technology, why they offer us to create it together with them, because with GSM technology you are more flexible. If senior will go, for example, to supermarket and something will happen with him, the system can trigger an emergency call anyway, and can also inform your relatives or doctors, and ambulance can be there immediately. So somehow this e-health systems help us to don't worry about our relatives anymore so much. And when we know that someone takes care about them. And it will give much more freedom to people in the future, I think, because we will all be able to feel safe even when we're far away from home and if we don't have any person next to us. So another case is an alarm system. What IoT brings nowadays to us is more that we're feeling also quite safe when we 10,000 kilometers away from our home, but we still can go online and lock our doors or open our doors. And what artificial intelligence on top of this, now one of our clients is creates a system that intelligence system can connect to your IP-based camera inside your home and recognize if there is a person, and if this person has a familiar face to your relatives, then it will not alert. But if there is someone, stranger, then it will alert, and to alarm system provider, also you will receive a message. So it really brings us to a next level. Plus, if it's a one global system, it's at some point can analyze the whole criminal situation in the city, for example, and predict when and in which areas it's a crime is much more possible to appear again, and that we need to provide a better security there. Another case is the retail stores, which is, you know, all these smart shelves nowadays when they can understand if there is not enough products anymore in the fridge, or some smart packages which can understand when the food is not fresh anymore. And this data is, of course, available only when it's very fresh, real-time data. Then only at this point we can use it. And what with this GSM solution which we have, the clients are super happy because you can distribute all these devices around thousands of shops you have, and you don't need to care which mobile operator exists in this area or not. Plus, if there is a network which is available on the border regions, it will switch all the time to the strongest one. And on the top of this are the intelligence system which they have, they analyze not only the quality of the products, it's also analyzed when is the right time to order new goods and when it's also kind of very suitable for predictive maintenance of different equipments inside the store, which is also a big topic. Next use case is, of course, automotive area, because now we have a lot of people who use electric cars and they all want to be informed when the battery is not so, the battery needs to be charged. And car rentals or delivery services, they spend really a lot of money and in fleet management, but they are not yet able to track the fuel consumption or mileage or everything that is cross-national. So they still need to find a connectivity solution when it could be possible to be done. And on top of this, intelligence system can analyze in real time the road which driver takes, for example, and predict which would be the best one, the weather condition, and also predict the maintenance, of course, for the cars. But at some point, one of our use cases, they use kind of a gamification for drivers. They analyze their driving style, how energy efficient it, how safe it was, and so at the end, they provide them kind of a rating system. And this system also find out the patterns, how to improve his driving style, what kind of suggestions. So it's also kind of a new epoch in automating area. Yeah, another thing is agriculture industry, and I really like this. There is this natural intelligence, it's somehow the way how the whole IoT will develop in the future. We need to really focus on natural intelligence because we know that each organism on our planet, each plant or animal, it's usually do the right thing at the right moment because they kind of programmed to do this way. I guess only humans do the weird stuff. And then, so nowadays, United Nations predict that in next century we will have 11 billions of people and they all have to be fed. But at the same moment, the farming is now has one of the biggest impact on our pollution. And of course, the next topic is the precision farming, how we can improve it. And now we have all these new technologies, intelligence systems, and drones, which can fly around the field, analyze where is the water or nutrition deficits, and apply it, for example, herbicides when it's only needed. There is also a new system which transfers data immediately. Analyze data immediately, I can transfer a specific animals to a specific field when it's needed. So it's really the only problem in this agriculture industry is that people usually don't have a lot of money to invest in it because it's basically still cost a lot for them. Plus there is another problem because the public is against to track animals, that it can be very bad for their health somehow. If, for example, track a cow and want to know about our milk, there is some people who are against it, and it's also understandable. So there is a lot of challenges in this industry, but it can really change dramatically the way of our life if we will find a way how to do a farming more precisely. And another is a smart home, of course. Can't avoid this topic, and it's very popular topic right now, and we all know that it's possible to measure all the temperature, air quality, and there is another way that within artificial intelligence, I guess it will be one of the cool examples that a washing machine can communicate immediately with a dryer and tell what type of load expect, what type of quality, and what a program it should use. So this will be a next level, which will save our time and energy. And all this smart home actually based on idea to save your free time inside the home. Now, I really like it because I hope that it will give us more time to learn new things or to read books or something like this. And yeah, there is also another interesting topic that there is a very popular nowadays this intelligence bots and application which can answer all your questions online, and Facebook really invests a lot of time to bring his normal messenger solution to a new type of like where you can do everything what you want, starting from games and finishing with a mobile payments. So it's one of the coolest technology nowadays which we created is artificial intelligence because basically on the first level which we provide that you can use a SMS API to send messages, and on the first level it will send them to Facebook, and only if there is no account created in Facebook. It will send it on a mobile phone. And on this level, artificial intelligence help us to do allocation-based marketing much more precisely and to track people and to understand who really needs which type of goods. This is scary, of course, but it's our future. It's not even future. It's not as fiction anymore. It's existing. And then, yeah, we've done one tracking project, and for donation, it was a guy traveled on paddling board for 12 days from Munich to Vienna. And intelligence, I mean, this was a SIM card inside of his tracker. Of course, it worked on the river, and it was very critical for him that networks can be changed, some networks can be unavailable anymore. But there was a system also which analyzed based on, because you can track him in real time on his website, so it could analyze what is the weather condition, what is social media activities right now on his website and Twitter, and what is when is the right time for him to do a break that he does not lose so much audience, which is looking at him right now. Yeah, and the cool thing is that for this, in 12 days, he used about 20 megabytes data transfer from SIM cards, being every second sending his location to the website. So it's really small amount of data, and it's really possible to do it very easily. Yeah, there is some small examples just because sometimes people ask, like, really SMS is outdated technology and how it can connect with artificial intelligence and so on. So it's just some explanation for the cases. Previous cases that, like, your device, of course, can send a notification to your mobile phone, or it can use an API and send all information. It's usually this case for alarm systems. There is another case when you can access a device. In Germany, we use it a lot to open a garage door. People like to arrive, call on the phone, or send a message, and the door is open, and magic happens. And there is also USSD. It's a very old kind of old-style technology, we think. But the thing is, when you don't have access to 3G or 2G, you still have a network, and you still can communicate. And USSD can open, you can open a dialogue, and also via API, and you can communicate. This is usually used, I know, but by ships who is traveling around the coast. So the internet access is not so good anymore, but they open this dialogue and can still communicate between each other. It's also quite secure because while this dialogue open, no one else can access it, only just two devices. This case we created with IBM together, and it's can possible to transfer your API call via SMS while you don't have a GPS coverage anymore. It's kind of an intelligent system inside which analyzes if there is an internet or not, and then it sends notification, but it's also learning during the time, so it doesn't waste time anymore if it's in the same location again. And it already knows there is no network, so I will send immediately it via SMS. So yeah, there is a map just with different conferences where I've been and talk about this. It's my Arduino device usually sent location. Yeah, we have a lot of different examples in our GitHub account that you can use with this technology. We also provide a developer package with 5 active SIM cards that you can immediately start today and create new IoT devices, and on top of it, create new ideas for artificial intelligence. And so the main goal, what the main purpose of my presentation, I would say, is just to bring awareness about IoT and artificial intelligence, and also that we all as developers really make all our individual efforts, bring it to actionable results which can benefit society and us in a whole. And that I hope that you learn some basics about how artificial intelligence can work with IoT, also how you can communicate between devices or different type of connectivities, especially how to work with a multi-network connectivity. And that's it. Yeah, please get in touch with me. I'm always happy to hear the feedback. I also very happy if someone got inspired today and will join IoT or artificial intelligence community, and we will create a lot of new cases and new projects together. Yeah. Thank you very much for your attention. Yeah. And I also have some SIM cards with me, a testing ones for free, so if you feel like that you would like to start something and try it out today, I can give it to you already after the presentation. So if there are any questions, yeah.
Yeah, I've got one. You said how IoT. How IoT doesn't work. Okay. Gather a lot of data. Mm-hmm. And how do you see the ownership of this data? It would be the users, the companies who create these applications, or governments?
No, I think the data belongs to someone who creates a project. So basically, the company owns the device, so it's their data. But of course, government can always have their own view on this data. Yeah. Is it?
Yeah. Just come from another talk about building a website on Mars and connect, you know, problems with connectivity, not being able to connect to the server. Are you guys looking into any kind of peer-to-peer communication where you don't have access to the server?
Yeah, we also do a PHP communication, and that API works on it, and it brings another overview on the work. And it's the only problem is that PHP has a time run, and it's always a little bit critical for us. But we're trying to work on it. We've just been 2 weeks ago on PHP conference in UK, had a talk about it, and it's also possible to do it.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Any other questions? Someone wants SIM cards. So thank you very much for your attention. Hope you enjoyed.